So it's 5:38, and I'll call the meeting to order. Is someone taking minutes?
I can.
Great. I forgot to look what I was doing. And it was an off week, or one week. So just so folks know, I have asked Lori if she would be willing to take over responsibilities for getting the agendas out and posted.
Okay.
Just so that doesn't happen again.
Yeah, I'm happy to do that.
Thank you.
And Karen and I will talk on the phone about what needs to go on the agenda. I'll also probably send out an email to everybody inviting you to give me items for the agenda.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so.
Thank you for that.
Sure.
Reluctantly bumping up against the limits of my mind's capacity.
Yeah.
So the first item is an approval of the minutes from the April meeting. It still is May.
No, it's actually the March meeting. We end up not meeting in April. Isn't that right?
Yeah.
Is that right?
No.
I have no clause.
Well, if that's true, then I give you the wrong minutes. Oh, I must just have the wrong.
Yeah, these the minutes from March 28th.
Oh.
But how can it say, oh yeah. So I think that we didn't meet in April.
I think we did.
You think we did?
So then didn't we discuss Pride, which was in May?
We did. Let me see.
Okay, so, well then, I gave you the wrong minutes.
April 25th, the agenda was wrap up of the civility campaign, a report on participation at the community conversation at the middle school, attendance at McKenton Pride, and the bystander training.
April was canceled, I see.
Yeah, I'm thinking, because that was, yeah.
Because that's why I brought these things, but also that's why we didn't wrap up the civility campaign.
Right.
I can't remember why, maybe we didn't have four.
Something about there being a very light agenda, and I forget, the email said something about there being a light agenda or something, and then I know I couldn't be there, and I think a couple other people couldn't be there,
okay.
So.
Okay, so good.
So, I'll change this to approval of the March minutes.
Oh, yes, right.
Lori sent us.
Yeah.
And were there any changes, corrections, additions?
I mean, I don't know. Actually, I did report accurately about the PDTA, but we didn't end up drafting a letter or sending it to the Gazette about the PDTA. I don't know how we deal with that on minutes. But maybe we just reflected today's minutes. That we didn't do that?
Yeah.
Yeah, so at that meeting, we did talk about the Pride March as new business.
Okay.
I'll move that we accept the minutes.
Second.
All in favor? Any abstentions? Oh, that's why the agenda looks so similar.
Yeah, exactly. That's why.
Okay. I'm just catching up here today. All right. So we will have, TBA is a tally on the total signatures. And how would we like to communicate the results of the civility campaign? I think is connected to the bystander training that a couple of folks went to. So, Lori, were you one of the folks who was there? Anyone else?
Chris was there.
Chris was there.
So, I thought it was fantastic.
Actually,
I thought it was so good that my office is planning a all-day school conference for the fall with those trainers.
Fantastic.
Yeah. It's really, they just do a really good job of helping you understand the dynamic and putting language to the roles people play and illustrating how the person who's targeted can also be a person who targets, you know, and that so that people aren't all one thing. And it makes, I think what I've observed is that it makes people better able to be open to it and less defensive. And they start with a simple exercise where you stand around in a circle and then they say things like, have you stepped forward if you have ever hurt someone? So it's just like, kind of makes you think about like, there are unintentional hurts and slights and it's a spectrum. And so anyway, I really thought it was great, but then they move on to how to be a good bystander. So that was great. And if this commission wanted to sponsor another one, I think it'd be great.
So we could sponsor an active bystander training, or we could, now that you and Christine have been to one, you could be trained as trainers of trainers.
Yeah.
And we could offer to train trainers in every ward in the city.
Oh, that's a great idea. Was that your idea in the beginning?
Oh, it was one idea.
Yeah, I think it's a great idea.
Do we have the capacity for that?
Well, that, yeah, I mean, if we did it slowly, we might, you know.
Is it something you would be interested in doing?
There's
an additional training to become a trainer of trainers.
Yeah, I think it's a full day. Yeah.
I think it would be.
I don't know when they're doing it next, but I can find out.
You can find out.
Yeah. And, I think there's going to be more of those two-hour ones, so if anybody wanted to join the ranks, that could probably happen too, or we could have one of those.
So my feeling is that we could host one of the two-hour trainings, or we could host a series of them, but my feeling is that if we maybe partner with each ward counselor to offer one in their ward, that we could magnify the number of people who could have access to the training.
Yeah.
For training trainers to carry on the work.
Mm-hmm. What I really like about that is that it feels kind of bad to me to think about taking those signatures and just saying, we got this many signatures, that's it, blah, blah. But if we were to say, we got this many signatures, and now we're doing this, it feels much more constructive. So I really like that. And it seems like something we could roll out in the fall and plan it during the summer. I mean, I would volunteer to reach out to the Quabbin Mediation since I'm already dealing with them about this conference. So.
Perfect. What about other folks? What are your thoughts?
Patriot, I think it's a great idea. It's a great way to continue the plan. I think was the hardest part of our pledge was how do you support people.
Right.
So it is the right thing to do. I'm staying quiet because I'm personally more involved with what we're going to be talking about later in the agenda. So I'm being careful about what things I say and how supportive I am.
Would it be helpful for us to talk about that part of the agenda? Okay.
I think they're independent.
Okay. Got it.
But there'll be parallel things.
Mm-hmm. I mean, we'll just need to reach out to the city councilors and see if they're into that, but I think some of them definitely would be.
Would they prefer to be reached out to one-on-one, or is this the kind of thing that do we make a proposal to the city council and inform all of them?
I think an invitation from Karen as the chair would be good to all of them together as peer pressure.
In But not, you don't mean in public?
No, I just mean in email.
Yeah, I don't want it to appear like public shaming.
Oh, no. No, I just think if they all, like, one of them starts saying, yeah, I'll do it, then the other, I don't even mean it in a shaming way, just like, just the spirit of camaraderie kind of.
Yes, yeah.
What do you think, Carl?
I definitely agree. It sounds good. It's something that I would like to get trained. I just don't know if I have the time to be that involved in it.
Yeah.
But the training definitely sounds like something I'm interested in.
I'm on board with it. Yeah, definitely. I think it goes in line with what we discussed before about doing like a safe space or type of training, something to go along with the signature. So this feels like maybe a safe space in a larger scale, like more in the community. Mm-hmm. So I'm definitely on board with it.
Would you want to be trained on?
Yeah, sure. Yeah, if there's a possibility for it.
I mean, I wonder too if we could get another trainer who's not on the commission. You know, maybe we could find another trainer.
Mm-hmm. You could ask and if they have any other trainers in their
family. Yeah, okay.
Great. Lori, from your experience of the workshop that you went to, were there any youth present, and is it something that would be appropriate to have at the youth generation in addition?
Absolutely. There were, I want to say there were like 40 people there and 20 of them. 15 or 20 of them were youth.
Fantastic.
Who came with their parents or, it was great.
It'd be great to get, well, maybe I'll ask the youth commission if they would like to partner with
us. Oh yeah, that's a good idea.
Is this plan of art? Ours require a vote? And is there a cost for the trainers, Lori?
I'll have to find out. I don't know the answer to that.
I'm confident we can get it covered.
Okay. And we'll have to ask Chris if she wants to do it.
Yes.
I guess I feel like because it's not exactly like a formal plan, I don't think we can vote at this point.
Yeah, it's just like looking into it.
Yeah, right. You're gonna look into it. Just we need minutes to probably figure what to do.
So if we meet next month, I would prefer to do a voting proposal, like when we say here's the date.
Yes, right.
And whether there are, and so then it's something that can others partner along.
Yeah.
This might be more for like that meeting, if it becomes possible, then like on campus when people were training for safe space training, they had the triangle with the rainbow on it in some people's doors and backpacks and laptops, so people knew like that's a safe person. So I wonder if we could draft something up that's like Human Rights Commission oriented, that people could have like on their cars or on the door, and so it gets the Human Rights Commission out there more, but also shows like people doing it maybe gains more interest and could become something larger down the road.
Yeah, it could even be like a sticker that says, I've been trained to be an active bystander.
Exactly, something like that.
So we have a plan to come up with a plan to share at the next meeting.
I don't think we finished the question fully about the communication plan to share the results with the public. I mean, mm-hmm. I guess it seems like we want to count them and maybe write a letter to the editor or a press release or something, but kind of link it to this other thing.
Agree. I think the best way to publicize what happened is to say, and now here's the next step.
Yeah, so.
So those two things will come back to June.
Yeah.
schedule, which is great because I know Carl has to leave a little early. And are you singing?
Yes, I am. All so right. I'm going to leave it.
I'll have to head out early too.
So. Great. Good. So moving right along. So thank you, Lori, for telling us about your participation in the Active Bystanders Program. Northampton Pride, I saw a couple of you. Mm-hmm. We didn't all get together for a picture. I think Joel and I took a selfie.
Oh, good. But you and Davina walked together?
And we walked together with the city councilors.
That's great.
Yeah. Anybody get any feedback or anything notable about this year's Pride celebration to share?
I wasn't able to go.
Yeah, I was out of town as well. It's my first time missing it in a while. Oh, sad to be.
My daughter was so mad at me.
It was a big one this year.
Yeah.
That's what I've heard. I was so mad that I missed it. And weather was great, and the last year it rained. So it was nice that it was sunny out this
year.
Yeah,
perfect day.
So I was been following this. I don't usually do this, but I've been following this thread on Northampton Facebook.
What is it?
This isn't.
What is it called? Is it only in Northampton?
Only in Northampton. Yeah. And it's this Ms. Durka. Did mm-hmm. you see that thread? This guy's very mad that people didn't go to the Memorial Day parade and more people go to the Gay Pride March. Anyway, it just made me think maybe we should go to the next Memorial Day parade as a Human Rights Commission. Give it some support.
For the record, it was a record turnout for that parade.
Aha!
It was the 150th anniversary. So it was a record turnout, but it was a smaller crowd than Pride Parade.
Yeah. It's just something I know, and we're not politicians, but all politicians go to these parades, and that's one way
well,
to get
a number things. Of the city councilors didn't march.
What'd you say?
A number of the city councilors didn't march.
At the
Memorial Day Parade.
Oh, they did?
No, I was standing in front of the Sojourner Truth statue.
Waving.
Next to Peter Ives and waving and applauding. And sort of, I mean, actually, I think it is a good idea that the Human Rights Commission should march in a parade like that.
Yeah.
And I think we should have that's the right thing to do. I was a little disappointed in how many, in terms of, you know, the mayor was marching and two or three of the city councilors were.
Yeah. I mean, it's just an easy way to get our name up and foster goodwill. The next one I can imagine is the Pulaski Day Parade in October.
Mm-hmm.
But it would be kind of nice if we had a Human Rights Commission banner to carry.
Mm-hmm. We can do that.
So I have to keep the t-shirt.
You gotta keep the t-shirt, and it'll be more easy. It'll be easier to wear it. In October than it was in December at Hot Chocolate Run.
Yes.
Yeah.
It's also notable that Congressman McGovern was there.
Yeah.
It's also, it's difficult because it's Memorial Day weekend, so I think, yeah, the population of Northampton thins out a lot. The college students who go to the Pride March have all,
yeah,
gone for the summer, so. And there are reasons why there's a size difference.
Totally, yeah. I mean, if you're a working person and you have a 3-day weekend,
you're going to go away.
There are a lot of people who don't have like a community that's a safe space, like Northampton is common to the Pride Parade,
yeah,
for that reason, whereas they might mm-hmm. go to the Memorial Day Parade in their own town.
Right,
yes.
Right.
Good point for
all those points were raised on that thread, by the way.
Yes, we don't have to solve the problem. We can show up.
Sure.
With our banner. Okay. Booker, have we heard about the community conversation?
Yeah, there's a lot to tell you about. Should we do it now as opposed to waiting until 6:10 p.m.?
I think we can jump the clock. Thank you for your appreciation for the
So the people who from Northampton Connects felt that the initial number, some of you were at that.
I was there.
I was there.
Maybe I should hear what you thought. We thought it went well.
Yeah.
And wanted to, and we've actually scheduled a second event.
Uh-huh.
That's part of what I wanted to tell you. And I think Northampton Connects would like it if the Human Rights Commission was, quote,
a sponsor.
A sponsor, so to speak.
So maybe that would be something we can put on.
Yeah.
Well, I just, in answer to your question, I thought it was great. And I really like the model of watching this conversation and then having this longer conversation. So it's just thought provoking to watch the panel have its discussion. What do you think?
I agree. I think the way that it was set up was, it was a way that people were able to discuss without there being like anger or, you know, arguments or things like that. I know that at my table I had a little bit of a hard time because most of the people at my table were all coming from the same kind of, like, they were more, when we discussed it, more like better off, like in terms of the socioeconomic status, and they were all white people, and so it felt hard to feel like I had to be the voice, even though we're only supposed to speak for ourselves.
Yeah.
I was getting turned to a lot as being a voice, so I felt like if there was more people like me there, I would have maybe felt a bit more comfortable.
Yeah.
And having like someone else to be able to like share their viewpoints and discussions and stuff, but overall I had a good experience. It was interesting hearing what people had to say, especially at the beginning when everyone stood up and gave their own stories about it. And it was nice to hear, definitely.
Davina was there also.
Yeah, I saw her.
I hope you do have another one closer to downtown, though.
So a lot of the criticisms were some of what you said. Not being downtown, not a truly diverse audience, and sort of how can we fix that? So the next meeting is actually scheduled to occur on June. Let me see if I got this right. The next meeting will be on June 20th. It's going to be at the Edwards Church. Mm. They have their manna dinner. The evening meal at 6:30, and it's going to follow that. And the hope is that some of the people participating in the dinner might stay and participate in the discussion.
That's a great idea. Is that a Thursday?
It's a
Wednesday.
Wednesday.
Oh, okay.
It's going to have a similar format to what occurred before, except only two or three panelists rather than six or seven to sort of allow more. A lot of us thought that the discussions around the tables was more rich than what allowed for the panel. And they're still working on who will be on the panel. Needless to say, a lot of criticism went on afterwards about not having people who are living on the streets as part of the panel. Some other issues, so that's all being worked on. There's also, so that's planned, and I think.
Did you say there's a topic?
It's probably gonna be the same start sentence, sort of, what do you like about Northampton, and what would you like to see improve, kind of opening question. Because it's, the feeling is that it felt better doing it from a place of love rather than what do you or what it means. So that's probably going to be the same, but hopefully different people in a much shorter discussion so that more stuff can go at other tables. We are not going to have Paula Green there. And there's still some question about who the facilitators will be or what the nature of that will be. So that's another change. Do you have other?
I did.
There are a few other events, by the way, that are also, I'm going to let you know about that are being planned that maybe we should depart.
Okay. Well, what time does it start? You say the manna.
Well, the meal starts at 6:30, and I'm not sure, and this would be after the meal, which might mean it's a true 7 or 7:30.
Okay. That's actually good for me because I have a meeting that runs until 7, so. Do we
want to talk about what we want.
Well, let me tell you about one other thing that's going to happen. Northampton Connects was also approached by the Sojourner Truth School that they're planning to have a listening session with the police chief from Northampton. And the idea is, again, that she would be there to answer questions about things that are going on, but they wanted to be a discussion or dialogue back and forth. It's not yet scheduled. It's likely to occur in the fall, but Northampton Connects is agreeing to say, yes, we'd like to help sponsor this event, and I think that's something we might wish to also be involved with. Mm-hmm. I think it's actually being run from people at the Truth School. That's actually where the it's mm-hmm. starting from. But we felt, since it's all about conversation and dialogue, that was what Northampton Connects did. There's some other projects that they're looking into, which aren't formed well enough yet to talk about here. Sort of fun, interesting things about different ways that people can get their stories. They actually want to start sort of a story core and sort of have a, maybe they're even approaching the Gazette about why not publish stories of people who live on the streets or business owners or other things, and just sort of start a bigger trove of stories. And apparently the Cathedral of the Night is also making videos of people talking about their experiences and that will probably be placed on. So sort of how can you maybe develop a bunch of trigger stories and trigger tapes that might be, instead of the panel discussions, then there's discussions afterwards. So, but that's all in the planning stage. So I guess what I'd like to propose is, could the Human Rights Commission, I don't know if the word is the co-sponsor or how to say it, but become part of or support from a publicity viewpoint and whatever the Northampton Connects program is going to occur on June 20th.
I think we should do that. Just better to work with people than start something on your own.
Mm-hmm.
I wanted to. Could I make a suggestion?
Mm-hmm.
So I like the idea of a listening session with the police chief.
Mm-hmm.
And I know that there's this DART program, which is this police initiative to respond to overdoses. So the police, there's a DART team that got this drug. I can't remember what DART stands for. Drug abuse. I can't remember what it stands for. But it's basically a drug overdose response team. So police department goes through the police log, and when there's an overdose, non-fatal overdose, they go to that person's house the next day and they bring literature and try to set them up with a recovery coach if they want it. And there's a lot of suspicion of the police department, and I think it could be good to have one or two of the DART officers with the police chief for this conversation. I mean, it's really something that actually does need help, right? Break down the barriers for it to work. If the community is suspicious of the police and their intentions, it's not going to work. So.
No, I think this is, I think they're anticipating that amongst how are the addictions issues being dealt with. My guess is there will also be discussions about surveillance, the new budgeting. There'll be a number of issues that come up. I think it's more of, I think, we're sort of interested in how can you do this all in a civil fashion, as opposed to, you know, in a way that it's very difficult to listen or communicate. So,
I mean, one way that I think you do that is you have people tell stories, as opposed to like state their position. Like in the small group that I was in, you know, instead of like a person just told a story, you can't really argue with a person's story that they're telling, you know? And I think that could work with this too. So if it's like Adam Van Buskirk, the Northampton DART officer, telling a story about how
house after they overdosed, it just shows his humanity, and it's something that you can't argue with. So, but then if there's somebody on the other side who has an experience where they felt brutalized by the police, they can tell their story. But it's just that whole using I statements instead of saying you police are abusers. So talk about what happened to you.
Yeah, I'm not aware of the formatting for this yet. I think it's more where will it occur, who will be in the room, and hopefully having a diverse group. The publicity is going to be really important.
Yeah.
And how it's framed as what kind of evening it will be.
So is this something that's going to be open to the public to attend?
Or? Yes. I have a feeling it's going to be in that conference room where we had one human rights committee, which is a beautiful room, but there's a sense that it would not be viewed as friendly and might be triggering for a lot of people.
Oh, that's where that conversation with the police chief would be?
Yeah.
Sojourner Truth School has already canceled one event
Because what?
Because it was held in the police station.
Oh.
And people who have had negative interactions with the police don't feel comfortable going into that building. The other concern I have is if it's only the chief and, 300 people turn out to ask her questions, that's it's not dialogue.
Well, that's why I'm suggesting the DART officers.
Right. But we're not planning it, so I don't know.
Yeah.
Well, we can suggest.
I'm sure there is going to be a lot of this. We spend an inordinate amount of time in the planning for that evening, assuming the worst, and we're pleasantly surprised that the worst didn't occur. And I'm sure the same thing will go on for this if it stays on. So do I take it that there's support for the Human Rights Commission agreeing to support Northampton Human Rights?
Right.
You want to make a motion?
Yes.
Okay. Was that a motion?
Yes.
Any more discussion? Booker, do they have specific responsibilities they want us to take on?
No. So Stan Shapiro is sort of the person running this at the moment. He's doing amazing work, so with everybody who wasn't at the meeting, he went and met with him. And there was a lot of writing on the web about what was wrong with the meeting, and he went and met with every single one of those people. And sort of is really trying to pull people who are concerned about being in the room for a variety of reasons, at least getting their voices. What can we do to make it so that you feel like you can come into the room? So he's doing amazing amounts of work. The other person who started Northampton Connects didn't fit well and decided to no longer be directly involved with Northampton Connects because it's confusing with the city council work and what he's doing. So he's actually backed away.
All right, if there's no more discussion, all in favor?
No opposition.
Okay. Thank you.
And at the next meeting, as I find out more about the possible meeting for the meeting with the police chief, I'll certainly let you know.
And we could have it be, we can involve what this relationship means, but it could be something as simple as we make every effort to have at least one human rights commissioner at each one of these. And they use our logo on their advertising.
Will you get the final details to me when we have them, and I'll put a flower back to everybody.
I think there's still a few planning meetings going.
Okay.
But the date, I mean, you're right, even the time is a little.
Yeah, we can do a hold the date.
Yeah, because this is going to happen before we meet next.
Right. So. We'll have quorums for our summer meetings. Davina will not be at the August meeting. Carla will not be at June or July. But those are the only folks I heard from.
Sorry, I won't be at the June one.
Okay.
I will be at July, and I will be at August, so.
All right, so unless there's a slew more that I hear from, then put those meetings on our calendars.
Okay.
And if we have this, if we're doing the bystander training for fall launch, we'll have plenty to talk about.
Yeah, right. Narelle, I'm wondering if maybe you could get the minutes out quicker than I did when it was my turn.
Yeah, sure.
For the people who weren't here.
Sure.
I almost think it's more important if people aren't here to get it out.
We still have a member opening on the commission. If that remains true in June, which I expect it might, maybe we could have something to hand out at the Northampton Connects.
Mm-hmm. Also, I was going to say, we had the flyers that Carlos O'Connor printed for the last one, but I didn't feel like a setting where I could just walk around and start handing them out. It seemed like it was more there for a different reason. So once I got there, I was going to stand by the door and hand them out, but then they had like people signing in and doing stuff. So I kind of just had them at my table, but that was really it. But I was going to say, hand them out and see if that's how you control
them. Yeah. Put them on some of the tables during dinner.
Yeah, exactly.
If you
I had a time with them to connect, so that way it's set up in advance, because otherwise I just felt like very imposing coming in. And,
yes.
Yeah, so back on. Yeah.
Does anybody have any ideas about somebody or know somebody you think would be good? Because if you do, you could encourage them to go online and live.
You know, the perfect person, but they live in Wheatley.
So. Oh, yeah.
Any new business?
So I'm looking for, I think many people know about it, but when the person who was in sanctuary in Amherst had his need for to be hospitalized at Cooley Dick for acute appendicitis, there was a lot of concern about how he'd get back to his church. And the Gazette reported this, a lot of people were aware of it, that the mayor got in the front seat of the car that drove him back to Amherst, which is a pretty brave thing to do. He could have been arrested for that. The other thing that did really, what I'm about to propose is that I think the Human Rights Commission should send them the public letters congratulating or thanking them for what they did. The other thing that occurred is that the president of Cooley Dick, Joanne Marcus, actually personally escorted him from out of the hospital to the car that was waiting to take him out. So those are two public people who really did something important and I think brave, made quite a statement. And I think I thought it would be good if the Human Rights Commission could write a letter thanking them for their work.
That's a really good idea. And public. Yeah, I agree.
There were a lot of other people who did things, but everybody else was ministers, not our church people.
Yeah, I thought it was really striking that the mayor did that, and also Joanne Bach, our PC. Yeah, that seemed like a good letter for our mission.
And speaking of people in sanctuary, is there an update on our own next door neighbor?
Right, she is still there. I don't, what do you mean update?
Well, she's still there, her case is still pending.
Yep, all of that.
All of that. Unfortunately, nothing has really changed except that she's here. Lot of support from the rest of the community in terms of people spending time, since there always has to be somebody in the church, there's a lot of volunteers from around Northampton who are being very helpful. It's pretty trying.
In terms of other new business, I wonder if we want to put this long letter, which they're asking us to read in full, on the next month's agenda. If you come, haven't read it.
That makes sense. I don't know.
Okay. You have a little bit.
Me neither.
Because I was unaware of.
I imagine that everyone's got a...
Yeah, so I can give Chris as hers. Anybody ever see Joel or Davina? Well, I'll email them and tell them I have it.
Yeah.
If they come up and ask me if I want it. Yeah. And then there's one for Brian Barnes.
I don't think we need to get him. Any other new business for the commission? Great. You can get to where you need to be. You can get there in time to warm up your voting cords. But only when we get the motion to adjourn.
A motion to adjourn.
Oh, I move to adjourn.
Second.
All in favor? Hooray.